Hey, Ars people.
Everybody's been wanting me to cover this Budweiser thing. Look, San Antonio Rodeo. I'm not a fan of rodeos. I used to like to go to them. I thought it was nice seeing horses do some things. But like with all horse sports, I finally wised up to the abuse and abusive techniques and how people will do anything in order to get people to clap for them and win a little medal or to feel important. So I think rodeos should be done away with. The reason why, I'm not saying government should outlaw them. I'm just saying people ought to stop supporting them. But it is what it is. Budweiser really makes a lot of emotional connection with people through their horses. They use these horses. Everybody, oh, they got great lives. They got good. This horse is probably lame and is put down. They're not releasing. They're saying all the horses should recover. That means they had to put that horse down. So this little horse, one of these two here, gets stepped on and hurt bad. And when you've got horses that are trapped and standing on you, you know, these horses weigh over 2,000 pounds, you're going to have serious damage to a horse. Plus, you have all these sticks. And when you have a 1,000-pound horse torquing and these get bent, could stab it. The way the horse walks off after this, I think it's his hip was dislocated or broken. Let's take a look at it.
And show you something very cool. Just like they did 100 years ago.
So we're still doing something that's really cool 100 years ago. The problem is these horses don't do this for a living. They don't do it every day. They don't do it 8 hours a day. They do it for shows. They practice once in a while. And it's not routine. So therefore, the likelihood of accidents is much higher. I will say this guy right here reacts very quickly and tries to get up there, but it's too late. Once you get these horses in a panic and they're trapped and they can't see anyway, it's hard to control a 2,000-pound animal because you're pulling on it. Even though Budweiser puts big-ass bits in their mouths to control them through pain and torture, it's still hard to control a horse when they're in a panic.
We're going to show you the knocking procedure. And we're going to turn down the music and want everybody to beat.
Okay, so you can see the guy moving his hands here a little bit, and I don't know if his intention is to get these horses to sidestep, to readjust. The two horses up front usually lead anytime you have. If there was only four horses, these two would be your two best, strongest horses. If there were six horses, these two would be your two best, most experienced, strongest horses. So these two horses up front are probably the best, most experienced. The problem is when you're getting them in these trap corners and they get trapped, you can't stop them and you can't get out of it. You can control them when things are going good and they're moving softly. But once they bind up, all the horses get nervous and panic and they all try to get free. And so you have a bunch of 2,000-pound animals trying to kill each other, which is why they shouldn't be doing this. This is bullshit. Budweiser's wrong. There's plenty of people talking about them. Of course, other people will be like, oh, they're good company. The horses do great. They're so pretty. They comb them. They take care of them. Whatever. It's bullshit. They're making money off these horses.
As quiet as you can so you maybe can hear the driver give those horses cues as he shows you how they knocked 100 years ago.
Boom. Right here. This guy sees the problem. So right here, this guy is distracted and paying attention to the dog. If you look back here, the dog is sitting with him, and then the dog climbs up here.
Show you the knocking procedure. And we're going to turn down the music and want everybody to be.
And it distracts this guy.
As quiet as you can.
Now, I don't know if this guy has a job, if he's supposed to be breaking or whatever. I'm thinking this guy steering is the guy in charge. But watch this guy's reaction. As soon as he sees his horse goes past the pivot line, he's like, oh, shit. Watch his reaction. When his horse turns, boom, trouble. Right here, as soon as this guy does that, it's like, oh, shit. These guys can't. This is trouble. This guy's like, oh, shit. Boom. He is down and running, but it's too late. These guys are already turned. You have these sticks. You have torque and tension. You have these collars. Rib cages, all these horses are feeling extreme pressure and pain. What this guy is trying to do is he wants to get around and grab this lead horse, because once you lead the horse, the rest will fall. But it's too late. They're already in a jam.
St. Louis, Missouri, or Kansas City, or...
And these guys are just pushing. Why are they pushing? This guy has no control with the reins now. The reins are designed to work in a straight line. So when you're pulling and you're giving tension, they're all getting a little bit of pressure. They each have reins. I don't know if they have all. Maybe the back two don't have reins at all. But there's usually a handful of reins. I mean, when I was moving two or four horses, there was you had a set of reins for each horse. And you just kept them separate for left and right. This is called plow driving or plow reining. These reins are on the left side of the horse, and these reins in this hand are on the right side. But this is just a disaster.
Chicago.
And they're pushing, and now these horses are trapped, and they're getting fallen, or trapped because their legs can't move, so they're getting knocked to the ground. And now this horse is the one that gets hurt. And I'm not sure which horse that is.
St. Louis, Missouri.
I think it might be this one. He gets totally screwed.
Chicago.
He goes down.
Uh-oh.
And now you have multiple horses on top of each other. And all the horses are trapped. All of them are panicking. All of them don't know what to do. No human can help. You see the posse coming out. Aw, shit. Shit's hitting the fan. Too late.
Here comes no. The crew. Here comes.
And this horse is panicking. And they're all panicking. And they're all getting hurt. And they're kicking. And when you got a 2,000-pound animal trying to free himself because he thinks he's being trapped, and you've got a guy, a horse on the ground, taking all these kicks and pressures and steps on, it's a disaster. I mean, it's so sad.
St. Louis, Missouri, or Kansas City, or Chicago. Wait a minute.
Uh-oh, that's not supposed to happen.
Here comes no. The crew. Here comes the team. Get them untangled. Hold on.
So he's trying to pull forward, but he can't. He's got a 2,000-pound animal in pain. And he's getting pressure, and the reins aren't working. The reins become non-effective. That's why when you rely on certain things on a horse, if your equipment fails, you have no control. So now you have eight horses in pain, getting multiple conflicting direction, pain in their mouth, pain in their hooves, trapped, torquing action from all these leather things. This is just a disaster. And you know what? They're going to say it's an isolated incident. It's a freak accident. We take care of our horses. They'll blame it on a horse. One of the horses panicked. One of the horses had a bad day. Doesn't matter who they blame or who's at fault. The problem is, shouldn't be happening, and the horse pays because a human wants to make money and get ribbons and wants to show off. It's bullshit.
Hold on. We've got professionals in place. Anytime you're in the rodeo business or the livestock business, when you're working with animals, you never know what can happen.
You hear this guy in the background, the rodeo guy? The people that runs rodeos are always saying the same shit. If you've ever been to a rodeo, every time a horse gets their leg broken, their back broken, somebody gets hurt with a stretcher, they have to bring out the meat wagon and drag a dead horse off with a broken leg. I mean, they've even shot horses in the middle of the ring because they were in pain and killed them. So rodeos have been killing and injuring horses for decades. So the guy who runs the rodeo is a freaking expert at remain calm. We have professionals. We have the best care ever. We have people here to take care of this. Sometimes with animals, things go wrong. We can handle everything, but we have a lot of professionals. We have vet care. These guys know what they're... He's a big distractor, the voice of calm, so the crowd doesn't get pissed off and go, what the fuck? Why are y'all doing this shit?
Now, I will tell you that there's about a dozen people that travel all over the world with this hitch. There's three hitches.
Oh, that's wonderful. They travel all over the world. There's a bunch of hitches. They're all professionals. They're all well-trained. Who gives a shit? Right now, this freaking horse that's going to lose his life because he's injured and they're going to end up putting him down, he doesn't care about all your bullshit you're saying.
They will travel 320 days a year. So everybody think positive, cross your fingers, cross your toes. The team that knows how to handle these big horses working at it right now. Yep, they have the very...
Okay, so this guy, these people do understand horses a little bit. And they have probably taught all these horses how to cover their eyes and to stop movement. If they haven't, they probably should, but I'm assuming they know what they're doing to a certain extent. The guy that jumped out immediately tried to get in there, was doing it. He's in green. I think he's the guy that says cover this horse's eyes, because then he won't see all the people and all the horses and try to get up and hurt himself more. So the covering of the eyes, good move.
The team that knows how to handle these big horses working at it right now. Yep. They have the very best.
Okay, it was the guy in the red that put it on. I thought the guy in the green gave it to him. Maybe.
Horse men and women that take care of them all year long.
Oh, they take care of them all year long. They get great vet care. They get good food. They have air conditioning. Who gives a shit, dude?
We have watched them thousands of times. And very, very seldom does anything go wrong.
Oh, of course it doesn't. Because you would absolutely videotape it if something went wrong and show everybody. The only reason we're seeing this is because somebody else videotaped it and released it. That's the only reason we're seeing this. So don't give me this bullshit about how great the horses are and how this never happens.
Very seldom like this, but you notice the first thing they do is they calm the other horses.
Yeah, this girl's really calm and look at her. She's in a panic. This guy's kind of standing around. He's like, whatever. I mean, what? You can only do so much. I mean, my first thing in this situation, because somebody's going to ask, well, what would you have done, Rick? Well, anytime a horse is trapped or in pain, you want to remove things that can hurt them, which they really can't do. You want to remove the pain sources like the bits, which should have never been in the first damn place. Then you wouldn't have to worry about removing it. And you ought to have some sort of quick release system so you can get these guys out of this. It's not like these horses are running 20 miles and they have to deliver freaking, life-saving measures to something on a bumpy dirt road. These horses come out here for a show. Why don't you have quick releases to where you can pull a pin and this thing pops off and these horses are free? Why do you even have these big bits?
It gives them the opportunity to do what they need to do to loosen the harness to totally free the one horse that is there.
These horses continue to move back. And it's not because they're moving back to hurt this horse. They're getting pressure and pain. I don't know if they've disconnected these reins. These reins should automatically be off. You don't want any other force or pressure on these horses. They're already getting extreme pressure. Crowd, noise, strange place, lots of people. Something that has never happened. A horse is on the ground. What do? I'm trapped. Every time this horse moves, it puts pressure. Every time they get pressure, they go, I gotta move. Every time they move, it puts pressure on another horse. Another horse goes, why am I getting pressure? I need to move. These guys are trying, I think, to stabilize all the horse's movement, which is probably what you should do, but they need to be stripping this gear and getting rid of horses. Every horse that can be released, cut, let loose should be out of this equation. You don't want multiple horses involved in this any longer than you have to.
You got to salute their ability to just hold those others to keep them gentle.
They're already in big shit about cutting these horses' tails off so it doesn't interfere with the other horses. Just for the show, these horses have their tails cut off, surgically removed. It's bullshit. PETA's on them. I know a lot of people don't like PETA, but at least somebody's giving Budweiser shit for deforming these horses and then claiming how much great care they get.
Well, they are some giants. There is no doubt about that.
I mean, this pipe right here should be released, and these four horses, if he's got control, should back up and be out of the equation. Now, somebody may say, no, it's better if everybody stays the same till we free this horse. I mean, I don't know. It's hard to say.
Our driver laying some of their holds. Well, his hands, he'll stay in.
You see these long sticks that are supposed to be underneath the horse? They're stabbing and hitting these horses' legs, putting pressure on the horses. You see them moving here.
Position on that wagon, help control the other seven horses. His shotgun driver, you can see he jumped off. He was the first on the scene.
I really don't understand why they aren't moving these horses forward. And just, I mean, nobody has a knife to cut some reins and to disconnect all this bullshit. These horses continue to move back. This guy's putting his hand. He's trying. Who thinks this guy is affecting this horse's movement? It's just instinctual that you try to stop this. But every time these horses step back, they create torque and pain and pressure and tight reins and tight pulling.
And realistically, that's his job. Make sure everything is right. If anything at any time goes wrong.
So I finally think this guy is disconnecting the reins. So this person who's pulling, and even if he's not pulling, these reins are only so long, so they're going through this horse, these horses, over the ground, through here. So these reins are tight and pulling. That's why these horses are going back. They're getting pressure on their mouth, and they're trying to relieve the pressure, saying, oh, I'm supposed to back up when I get pulled on my head. So this guy, I believe, is removing
there,
the reins
jump
now.
Jump in the position and get after it. So trying to get him unhooked right now. Say a little prayer. I'm sure everything's going to be fine, but it never hurts to say a little prayer to have the good Lord look at.
Finally starting to remove, I want you to watch when this horse just shakes his head, the movement of everything that he causes, just by moving his head up and down. Then you add two or three 2,000-pound animals taking one step. Imagine the torque and force and the things that they're causing. Watch this horse head when he moves his head. Watch these things rattle and move.
Everything's going to be fine, but it never hurts to say a little prayer to
look at that.
The good Lord look after
everybody moves. Why? This horse, that they're all connected. Everything that one horse does creates pressure on every other horse. This is just, I mean, you really couldn't plan a disaster like this any better. There ought to be much more safe holds on how to immediately disconnect that this could not happen. But you know what? Rick, then it wouldn't look pretty, and then we wouldn't look original, and it wouldn't look like it used to look, and we have to make it look cool so people can clap, and so we can get free advertising for Budweiser, and we can feel like we're, tell everybody we're giving these horse, it's just bullshit.
Randy mentioned it at the beginning of our performance. Our rodeo business is nothing without our animals, and we love them, I can promise you that. We'll let them go to work, take their time, just like we do with our cowboys. We have the Justin Sports Medicine team for the contestants. We have veterinarians.
So this guy is taking time wrapping reins. I don't know why he's not moving that horse away or moving him forward or trying to do something. See, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different people. You have 8 horses. This guy isn't doing anything, which he really can't. His job is to stay up there and try to control the horse as best he can from up there in case he's needed. So you have 8 horses and 7 different people not knowing what everyone else is doing. And it's just a freaking disaster.
On duty all the time, 24-7, whenever we're rodeoing, we've got them here and ready to take care of our livestock, no matter if it's a saddle horse, bucking horse, bull.
So you see this guy feeding the rein through the other horses to release some pressure here.
Maybe even no matter if it's a saddle horse, bucking horse, bull, or maybe even one of our big Clydesdales. This is the first.
I think this wood is all cracked. I'm not sure that wood's supposed to be torn up like that.
Maybe even one of our big clients.
Look at all this heavy wood and hinges and torquing and pressure and pain and stabbing instruments. But Rick, it looks so pretty when they walk. Shut up.
This is the first day we got to see him, Randy, and I was so looking forward to it.
Yeah.
They're such a class act.
And I guess I would say...
Okay, finally! They get these two horses out of here. Now, this horse isn't flopping around because they're sitting on his head and they covered his eyes. And if you control a head, the horse can't get up. So by two people holding his head down is why he's not thrashing in pain and trying to stand up. He's going to try and stand up here in a minute and he can't.
The intricacy of...
So his leg right here looks deformed to me. When he walks off, he's what I'm calling short-stepping really bad.
Putting the harness work on these horses, you see all of that.
So this guy is massaging this area because I think he knows something's wrong. You see the his hand going in and out of his hip.
The harness work.
Watch
on
his pushing action.
You see,
is he just petting or pushing?
That beautiful harness work, the lines, the tugs, the...
Maybe he's just columns, petting.
All of that.
I thought he was trying to see if the leg was out of socket.
These guys are experts. And when you got a situation like this, they have got to be undone pretty much in the same way. I mean, they've got to know exactly what to take off
Now, this guy's like running up. I'd be cutting shit. If I was doing this, I'm cutting shit. I'm not going through all this feeding and taking time and maybe increasing a reaction or a slap or a rub. I'm just cutting the shit. Cut these horses loose. Destroy the damn equipment. Quit trying to save it and get these damn horses away. This guy gets these two horses out of the way. He's out of it. Good deal. Good job. This should have been done, I think, a lot quicker.
And we thank everybody for allowing us the time to make sure that...
Hear this guy in the background talking? He's saying all calm shit, and I'm telling you what's really going on.
We're okay. Because the last thing we want is any undue injury, unnecessary.
Yeah, no, but no, it's easy to say, I don't want a horse injury. Then don't put them in a dangerous situation where they get hurt like this. It's easy to say, I didn't want this horse to get hurt when I ran him off a cliff. I thought he'd hit the water. I didn't know the water wasn't deep enough. I didn't want him to get hurt. I just ran him off a cliff so he could get in the water. Yeah, whatever.
On that horse, or any of the others that are in that line as well.
All these horses shaking their heads because they're all still connected. They're nervous.
Hours a day are spent not only cleaning and shining and making sure that everything looks beautiful as it does right now in front of us, but also get those horses hitched up, washed every day. Here's just a couple of interesting little things we had on our notes here. Usually we don't have time to talk about.
So they got the other horse out of the way. That's good. Got him disconnected. Move him out of the equation. Get him moving.
Just something to think about. In two daily meals, these horses will consume 5 gallons of feed.
Now let's start talking about how great care they get to distract that this horse is in extreme pain because of this bullshit.
50 to 60 pounds of hay. 30.
Why is this horse still here? Get him away from this guy so...
Gallons of water each. Some big boys right there.
Now this horse, this guy has been kneeling on this horse's head for a long time.
So, you know, in that hitch formation too, you've got the lead, you've got swing horses, you got wheel horses. Wheel horses, I think, are still totally attached to that wagon, along with the ones right in front of them. I got to tell you that...
This guy's an idiot. There's no reason to walk this horse close to this horse. You're an idiot, dude. You walk him around, you give this horse extreme leeway. He's on the ground, he's in pain. The quicker you can give a open area and not do anything that could freak him out, the better. You're an idiot.
Rick, he's the most professional, and he's been working with these horses for 100 years, and you don't know what you're...
Whatever. He's an idiot. This is not a horseman's thought process. Nobody that understands a horse is on the ground in pain with a lot going on is gonna needlessly walk a horse by him. There was no reason to do this.
It's just stupid. Those are the most powerful four of that entire hitch.
Now I'm gonna walk him by his back legs. Maybe he'll get stepped on. Yeah, that's a good idea. Let's put him right here so if this horse backs up into this horse, he'll step on this horse. That's a great idea.
Once you get in to that first pair up front, the lead, and those right behind him, they're a little bit more athletic, they're a little bit lighter in weight, but every one of them provides a lot of power to pull that big old heavy wagon.
So the way he's putting him next to this guy, I'm just guessing. I'm maybe giving him an excuse. I still think it's stupid. It almost seems like he's pushing the next guy to kind of calm these guys down, or so these guys don't run off. Maybe he is one of the more experienced horses because he was higher up in the chain. Remember, your most experience is here, your next experience here, your next, and your newest, youngest horse here. Maybe these four are really young and inexperienced, and so they wanted to give them confidence by putting this guy in front so they wouldn't run off. I don't know. Maybe. But he still shouldn't have walked that horse that way. He should have walked the horse all the way around here in front of these two and brought him over there. So I still stand by. Walking this horse by this horse was bullshit move.
So our teamsters of today.
So they get off his head, and they're moving this blanket off while this guy's carrying large white things by his face. Bad timing.
Are known as truck drivers, like the Teamsters Union, right?
Yep.
They got their name from the team.
So this horse tries to get up, and he can't.
Teamsters of yesterday.
So he tries to get up and falls where? Toward the other horses that haven't been moved. It's just so freaking frustrating when I see people doing stupid shit with horses like this. This horse should have this whole arena cleared. And instead, now he's falling and stumbling into other horses that are tied up. Perfect.
Hey buddy, I have full faith that that horse is fine. And just like
so what do we do? We'll pull on a pain bit and pull his head and use pain so he doesn't fall into the other horses. Perfect.
You never know. Anything can happen anytime, anywhere.
Oh, he's falling into horses, Rick. Why are you always picking on men? Why are you always picking on these people? Look at this shit. You guys are supposed to be horsemen and understand horses and predict problems and see around corners for horses. And you do this? I mean, it's just absurd to me. And there's going to be people here, Rick, you think you know everything and you're perfect. They're trying to do the best. I don't care about trying when it comes to horses. When horses get hurt, I don't care about whether you tried or you feel good or it hurts your feeling. I don't care. I care about doing what's best for the horse. And none of these idiots are using their damn head. Look at his horse. He's exhausted. So where does he lay down? He lays down at the hooves of the two most inexperienced horses in the wagon because it hasn't been moved. Are you kidding me?
So I've got to watch and keep an eye on all of those around me. Their main concern is the betterment of that horse.
So we have an animal care unit. If we need to transport any livestock, even a 2,000-pound bull, we're able to do it. But
oh, here's a good idea. A stumbling horse that's hurt, that's almost fell on these four horses, I'll bring another horse closer. Are you kidding me?
Animal care unit. So I think, I'm just guessing here, that the professionals down there handling them.
Okay, so this guy's leading away. I'm not sure what happened. I got so frustrated. I haven't even watched. I don't even know how they get out of here. I'm assuming if this guy's walking away, they're going to try to use him as a draw to pull these other horses. And they'll probably turn this horse and put him in front. But we'll see. I don't know.
Horses. I think they still have full faith that the horse is fine. But they're checking him out, working on him. You know that his heart's got to be beating pretty fast. That's for sure.
All right, so again, I say that they have lined that hitch back up. I think the wheel horses and ones in front are going to ease that wagon around. So it's out of harm's way.
Gee, we couldn't do that when the horse was over here and it would have been safer and better. We had to wait till the horse stumbles into them. This is why I'm calling these guys idiots. Nobody's freaking think. You would think. These guys do this for a living, that they would know what the hell they're doing.
Not going to be of any harm to that horse. Well, really.
This should have been done immediately as soon as this horse was free. In my opinion, I'm sure I'll have somebody out there that tells me I'm full of shit and I was wrong. Whatever.
I've got to salute the ground crew. They were there so quick. And with all the whereabouts.
Oh, let's all clap. This horse is in pain on the ground. Let's all clap because they figured out a way to move horses.
Okay,
really?
Thank you for doing that for me. You know, when I tell you there's so much that's got to be done to get you and put all that together, you've got to reverse all of that, especially when you start with a middle horse like we have.
What did that thing come flying off? Okay, so this guy takes off his face and throws it. I probably wouldn't have done that. I would have moved it behind my head, moving slowly. You don't want large actions that can startle a horse. This throwing this thing in the air. probably not the smartest thing in my book.
With a middle horse like we have,
so even our novice fans that are here watching for the very first time can...
So they're trying to pull gear off this horse that's 2,000 pounds and laying on it.
Identify with the heartfelt love that these people have with these horses. It's just like with your dog or your cat at home. It's part of the family. And once again, the reason why we're taking all the time that we need. If it comes down to the livestock, we can take all day if we need to.
They will. This crew is so very proud of those horses and love them so much.
Oh, this crew loves their horses so much. It's a freaking job. Nobody that loves horses could see these horses put through this shit.
They spend, you know, every hour of the day, weeks on end, on the road, caring for. I have seen these 40 years in the Clydesdales that I have had.
So everybody's happy now. I want you to watch this horse's back leg as he walks off. This horse is in extreme pain, and he's got serious damage. And Budweiser's only releasing little clips saying, all the horses should recover fine.
They don't push it. They make sure they know that that animal is okay.
So now we're going to turn this into a huge success, and what a great job they did. They caused all this, and now we're going to turn it into a huge success.
More than asking to totally stand, I would like for you to salute that crew that's down there again. They are so unreal in their care. And I promise you, you see...
Watch this short step. This horse is in a lot of pain.
See that Clydesdale walking out of here. Perfectly good. I don't see any limp or anything. I'm going to tell you, they're going to go right to the vet. He is going to totally examine
them. Yeah, go right to the vet. They'll put him down. Or they'll keep him alive for a few days so they can do a repertoire that the horse is getting care. And then we'll put him down 2 days later.
That animal, they will look over the rest of them that were in that hitch as well. They are a beautiful, beautiful presentation.
Oh, that was a beautiful presentation. Wow, that was wonderful. Yeah, as you can tell, I'm not impressed. All right, I've been getting a lot of heat on covering the Budweiser accident. So I did. And you can hate me in the comments because I'm being mean to the poor men that did such a great job. Everybody always telling me when I'm cracking on women that I hate women. Let's see how many men come here. Man, why you always picking on men? You just hate men, man. That's not fair. Those men were doing a good job. Let's see how many men come here crying like that. Like all the women that come here crying. All right, we'll end that there.